Well, my editing skills are crap, but can the same thing be said about Amazon Prime's Bliss? Stick around and find out. I couldn't think of a song to go with this, so you just get a little bit of fanfare for the common man. Don't read into that too deeply. It has nothing to do with this movie. Hi, I'm Peter Franson from ChristianGeekCentral.com and Spirit Blade Productions. This is my uncut review of Bliss, which has just come recently to Amazon Prime from Amazon Studios. The synopsis on Amazon and on IMDb reads, Bliss is a mind-bending love story following Greg, who, after recently being divorced and then fired, meets the mysterious Isabel, a woman living on the streets and convinced that the polluted, broken world around them is just a computer simulation. Doubtful at first, Greg eventually discovers there may be some truth to Isabel's wild conspiracy. All right, so what is this thing? Watching the trailer might give you one impression over the other. The basic feel of it is it's a heavy drama, you know. Prepare to sit in a sad, somewhat depressing state for much of this movie. I got an idea of kind of what's going on. As far as, like, is this one of those movies where you're, like, questioning reality the whole movie? I don't think so. Maybe audiences aren't intended to figure it out as soon as I did, but I don't think it's supposed to be a secret. I think you're supposed to know kind of what's going on within the first 20, 30, maybe at most 45 minutes of the movie, and then the back half, I think everyone probably will have a clear idea of what exactly is going on. And then, so at that point, pretty early on, I kind of realized or strongly suspected and then felt like I'd gotten enough confirmation to know, okay, this is what's going on here. And then that affected my mood and how I interpreted the rest of the movie, which really made it kind of a sad experience to me as I watched and waited to see where the characters would end up. Because I think as an audience, we are kind of tuned into what's going on long before the characters are, which isn't often the case in movies like this where there's reality that's kind of being questioned. But I don't think that hurt the experience. I think actually, like I said, that it's probably the intent that the audience figures out long before these characters what's going on around them. I think it's better if you go in expecting a straight drama or like a fantasy drama. Don't go in with the expectation of like heady sci-fi. So this is, you know, it's not that kind of movie where you're like, it's like deeply philosophical or conceptually intellectual, you know. It's not that kind of thing. The sci-fi elements are very present and visually they're, you know, throughout the movie, but it's not a real intellectual brainy kind of plot. It has a few funny moments here and there as the characters use the extraordinary powers that they have to manipulate the world around them. There are some sci-fi and fantasy concepts that are very lightly explored, but most of this is a serious, very emotionally grounded drama. Now, as far as the cast goes, you will probably recognize, let me see here, Owen Wilson and Salma Hayek. And they're the two leads, and they're both great in their roles for my taste. Hayek stands out in particular as giving varied and fitting performance styles depending on which world the characters are in, which does have a major effect on how her character is portrayed and how it comes across. The world itself has an effect on her character, and that feels very appropriate to me. The supporting cast around them I felt was solid, though not stand out really in their performances, but nothing that I would say distracted me from the story. As far as the visuals go, visual effects are fairly frequent, but they're not spectacular, and definitely not industry standard. It reminds me of the visual effects quality you would likely see in a comedy sci-fi movie, where they know that the main selling point for this is not the visuals. It's not for a hardcore sci-fi audience necessarily. They're leaning on other things, and so they don't put as much budget or time or whatever into those visual effects because they're leaning on the jokes in the case of a sci-fi or fantasy comedy, right? Now, this is not a comedy by any means, but that's just the comparison I would use to describe the quality of the visual effects. The movie is still, though, very visually interesting to me as the two worlds that the characters are in begin to kind of interplay with each other, becoming blended as you are using the visual elements to try and sort through what's really going on. So visually, it's a very interesting experience. I have often felt wonder and excitement while seeing sci-fi visual effects in movies. This might be the first time where science fiction visual effects made me feel sad almost every time I saw them. And I think you'll need to watch the movie to know why that is the case for me. So I felt like they really are a great device that serves the drama of the story very well. Now, as far as themes, is there anything of moral, philosophical, or spiritual significance going on in the themes of this thing that might stimulate some worthwhile thought or conversation? Yes, I'm not going to comment on those themes with any specificity. There's a rich theme that drives the movie, but to talk about it in any detail is to spoil a major plot element. So I'll just say this, although I don't think we are meant to be puzzling through what is real and unreal beyond the first 20, 30 minutes, I could be wrong, so I'm going to record a spoiler car video, which I haven't done many lately, and that'll go up first for patrons over at patreon.com/spiritbladeproductions. I think it's patrons of the $5 tier and higher, maybe. And then it'll go out to everybody on the Christian Geek Central YouTube channel, probably in about 3 weeks. That's usually kind of the delay on movies that are like direct-to-video, direct-to-streaming services. But anyway, that's where I'll really go into spoilers about the movie and then talk openly about the themes, which I think you can only do when you're willing to spoil the movie. But the themes are very strongly present. They're the driving force of the movie, the driving force of the drama, very grounded in real-world struggles that many face or watch loved ones face, and I think it handles those themes well and provides a bittersweet yet hopeful ending in kind of its message. Now, I have no idea what your tastes are in movies, but if I were a time traveler, I'd go back in time and say, Vader. Okay, definitely watch this one. Maybe with your wife, too. She might be able to really appreciate this. Don't expect a drama version of The Matrix or a deeply intellectual sci-fi concept movie. It's a character drama with the trappings of sci-fi and fantasy, very grounded in real-world issues, but presented in a way that's going to appeal to your interest in both geeky ideas and human drama. This one is rated R for drug content, language, some sexual material, and violence. All right. Those are my thoughts. I would love to get yours in the comments below. Please like, share, subscribe, click that bell to stay connected. I want to thank the Spirit Blade Insiders for making so many of my reviews possible. You can get info about the benefits of joining at patreon.com/spiritbladeproductions. And then I hope you'll join us soon over at christiangeekcentral.com as we continue to geek out and seek the truth.